Smell that? It's time for a swing dance reaction video.
No. No. No.
Yes!
Woo! Welcome to Street Smart Swing. My name is Jamin Jackson, also known as the Galactic Swing Dance Umpire, and I am super excited to be scrutinizing another Lindy Hop competition. This time, it is going to be at TBK 2019 in Seoul, South Korea, one of my favorite places to swing dance in the world, if not my favorite. And I cannot wait to get into this competition. Are you ready for it? This is going to be good. It's only 3 minutes and 12 seconds. It looks like it is basically two couples. Yeah, this is it. So I've got to really look at this. We're going to battle it out. I'm going to tell you what I'm looking for afterward. Blowing kisses to the camera. I love it. First couple. Yes. That's good. That's good. That's better. Ho, ho, ho! Ah, that was good timing, guys. Come on. Yes. That's what I'm feeling. Yes, I would love that 3 minutes and 12 seconds of my life to continually repeat. I've got to say, I love watching Korean dancers. I don't care what anybody says. It is probably the best place, in my opinion, to swing dance in the entire planet. I've been to so many different places, and this place is electrifying for me. And this couple, these four people were really putting in their all. I really liked the fact that it was these four couples that were in the finals. They were evenly matched. What I liked from both of the couples is that they both were aware of the music. They didn't just do a bunch of moves. They were listening to the music. That's a really good song. And I like the Charlie Christian version of that song. And it seems like some of these dancers knew the song because they were able to do some syncopations together in time with the music. Some of you all may not know me, but I like to be very specific with the words that I use to describe swing dancing, because there's a lot of different ways to describe something that is simple but yet very complex. And so I don't want you to be confused at all by the usage of that word syncopation. For me, I simply use that word to describe a moment in your dancing that is a rhythm inside of a rhythm. Right? We have the swing metronome that's continually going. That allows the musicians to stay in rhythm, and it also helps the dancers dance to the music. But we also have options to do different things on top of the swing metronome. And those things, if we were doing syncopations, can either impact our partner's movement or they don't necessarily have to impact their movement. And so both of these couples were doing a lot of syncopations. And I will tell you, folks, when I'm judging people in Korea, it's a whole nother standard, because ultimately Lindy Hop is subjective. I'd say 75% of it is. Don't listen to what anybody says. There's so many different ways to do the same thing, but what it is that we're actually doing is the objective thing. That it just so happens to be that it is decorated with different personalities and styles. So that little thing I have to talk about is the word control, because there's various techniques that you can use to share energy with your partner. That's the way I look at Lindy Hop. You have a leader, you have a follower, they come together as one body and they share energy at different points. And there's different ways or techniques to manipulate that energy to create a certain aesthetic that fits your fancy, right? And so for me, I don't like to, you know, dive too deep into the creative choices that people made for the technique. I don't want to say, oh, their swing out wasn't smooth enough. That's personal preference for me. So what I have to go by is, did they look controlled doing whatever stylistic choices they wanted to do? And that's pretty simple. These couples are at the top level. And so both look controlled. They could do swing outs. They could do tuck turns. They could do Texas Tommies. They knew how to fill in the space with improvisation. So what I have to do from that starting point is then immediately go into the realm of subjectivity and let you know that I'm being subjective. Because these two areas that I'm judging them on are really helpful for the dancers to get an emotional reaction from the audience, but they're not necessarily objective for dance in general. They're just simply not, right? It's a matter of preference on how you want to do these two things. So take that with a giant grain of salt. Timing is important to me. Timing is incredibly important when you're doing a battle format like this. When you have two couples, they're going at it, because the audience is ultimately the recipient of the emotional impact. And we want to feel something, right? There's music that's playing first that allows the dancers to feel an emotion and embellish that visually, but then the audience is the one that receives everything. We get to hear the music, but we also get to see the dancers either amplify what we hear or diminish it, okay? And the dancers do that visually. So the timing in this dance, this competition, was interesting because both dancers knew how to fit the basic macro timing, and that's the phrasing where it might have 3/8 counts, and then the fourth 8 count of that musical phrase is the kind of transition 8 count to allow the phrase to repeat again. And so these dancers were well beyond that level. They were not just gonna do that and just do like a little simple Susie Q or something. they were beyond that. They were trying to creatively do things in a very micro level of musicality. And I appreciate that when the level of dance is really high, because it lets me know that you can do something that is clear for me to listen to, but you're trying to do it in a way that's creative and not insulting my intelligence, right? And so these dancers both were doing some like amazing syncopations. The followers were just like following it. And it was beautiful. It was beautiful. Now, there are two types of leading that I like to talk about. And we talk a lot about this in my school. You have actual leading where you're focused on sharing energy with your partner, where the leader sets up some energy, the follower allows the energy to hit their body, and their body moves until the energy runs out or something changes. But then we have suggestive leading. That's when the leader like suggests something, and then the follower's like, yeah, let's do that, right? And there's many of those moves in swing dancing that we have to honor. Sometimes people will do the little point, the little Frankie point. I like to call it the Leon James point. And there are a lot of different moves that are just traditional swing dance moves that you're not really following using the energy to make that happen. You're actually just looking at a visual cue and you're matching your partner. So both, there was one couple that was able to do that better than the other couple. In my opinion, the couple on my left had a lot of moments where they both were just doing visual cues, right? And let me see what they were wearing, just to make sure I'm not losing my mind here. Yeah, the couple that he was wearing all black, she had like a flowery shirt. They both were doing a lot of visual cues that were great. And that's good. But when I am ultimately trying to judge a competition, I never use the visual cues of leading and following as the ultimate standard. Those are secondary cues. Those are the cues that really put the cherry on top when the competition gets close and, you know, the leader and the follower do something that is super hard to suggest and to follow and nail it, and the audience goes wild, then I might give the upper hand to that couple. But ultimately, I like to see people share physical energy, because that's the thing that really makes this work, you know, when we start moving together. And so I have to give the edge of suggestive leading to the partners on the left, but actual leading for me and following, I gotta go with the couple on the right. The leader had the blue shirt and follower had like a white shirt when it was striped. They were cleaning house. Their first set, they had a little move that they were doing that I know is difficult to do because it wasn't just a rock step or a triple step, right? Rock steps are to change direction. Triple steps generally are for traveling, right? And they weren't using those. They were doing like this little skip hop, skip up cross. And he suggested that with a rock step and then led his partner, and she was able to follow that stuff in perfect time. That's the hard stuff in competitions that get extra points, because you can easily botch it and everyone can see it because they took a risk and it failed, right? But in this case, they took a risk and they nailed it. There were a couple of moments also in the music where I know the music was modulated and climbing and the guitar player was continuing this riff, and the dancers with the blue and the white, they totally like repeated it. They did some syncopation, they did three swing outs, and they waited, and she waited, he waited, and then they did something with their feet. They waited again, and I literally felt like in my mind, please do it again, please do it again. And they did it like twice, and I just got an emotional reaction, all right? I got a little excited, I'm sorry, but that's the goal for me as an audience member and a judge, is to think, who can give me an emotional reaction that is not cheap? Right? That's why you need judges, because the audience, they're not good enough to discern what's actually good, what's hard to do, what's well-timed. All they know is something shiny! Woo! Right? Or my favorite person! Woo! That ain't gonna cut it. But when you can get an emotional reaction from me, from something that you're actually doing, that I know as a professional dancer is different and difficult and was risky, then I will tell you right then, that is good dancing. So for me, If I had to give a trophy in this competition, it would ultimately go to the couple on my right, which is the couple with the blue and the white. He had yellow hair. She had a red hat on. They were phenomenal because the things that I alluded to earlier. They were able to do suggestive leading, some of those things they suggested, but I was more impressed with the actual leading and following of the energy. They were in time together. She was following hard stuff that he was suggesting, and they together were able to make it happen. And that's very, very difficult to do in a competition. I'm much more forgiving if they, you know, try something like that and mess up just a little bit than I am for someone who's going to play it safe. And I'm not suggesting at all that the other couple played it safe, because they were doing a lot of syncopations that were more on the visual cues. So she was able to watch what he was doing, and they both hit it in swing time because they both probably knew the song was coming up in a section that they were familiar with. And they were able to do that well. But ultimately for me, it's what are they physically leading? And the timing that goes with the music, that elevates the music. I want to just literally go back on that part where they were just pausing and then doing something with their feet three times. I just want to put that on repeat. I could literally watch that over and over and get the same feeling. And I love that. So ultimately, that couple on the right is my winner. And they were phenomenal. So what do you guys think about this Jack and Jill competition, this advanced one? This finals, I will tell you right now, advanced doesn't mean advanced in Korea. I'm telling you, it's not the same. Their novice is American advanced. So if you're offended by that, take it like a man or a woman and get in the studio and start practicing. It's a whole nother level in Korea. So I'm interested in seeing who are going to not just both focus on being safe as a technician, but I want to see the artist of tomorrow, because I tell you what, I'm telling you right now, in the next couple of years, if a Korean couple gets this American attitude where it's like, you know what, I don't care who you are, I'm just going to try this crazy move and bust it out in your face. If something like that happens, plus the technicality that's in Korea, it's a Korean dance. I'm just telling you right now, that's what will happen, because there's such a disparity between the level of excellence and craftsmanship than it is anywhere else in the world. It's just, for me, as a whole, I'm searching for the artist in Korea. I'm searching for the uniqueness, the couples that are willing to take risks, not just to be a gimmick and stand out to be a flash in a pan. I'm looking for the artists of tomorrow who are going to influence many dancers that are not just Korean, but dancers who aren't even born yet in the future. So think about that. That's how deep this is with the technology that we have. So what do you guys think about this competition? I had a really great time watching that 3 minutes and 12 seconds of loveliness. Let me know what you guys thought in the comments section. If you are wanting to get better at Jack and Jill's or just social dance in general, if you want to make your dancing look flashy and figure out how to do that, I would encourage you to check out some of my free courses. I have a home studio here. We have a community online where they push me to basically come up with new stuff every single week. And I'm doing that and sharing those ideas with them in hopes that it sparks a love for creativity and a drive for them to be able to find their unique mark and place that on Lindy Hop for the dancers of tomorrow. Now, if you were like me when I first came into Lindy Hop and I was like, listen, I don't have time for all this politics stuff. I ain't got time for all of the other stuff. Just show me how the dance works and get out of my way, because I like the dance more than any of this other stuff. That was me. If you want to just know objectively how it works, without all the subjectivity that goes on to that, just to figure out the mechanics in a very simple language and a streamlined approach so that you can fix yourself on your social dancing, I encourage you to check out my Fundamentals membership. I put about 10,000 hours of study and dance and social time and teaching, and it was all so much fun, but it wasn't fun to not know the answer when I was in that process. I just kept doing research and kept trying to figure out what was absolutely necessary and what wasn't. I got all the way down to the studs in Lindy Hop. And there's only a few things that you absolutely have to be doing to make it work where you can dance with anybody no matter what their style is. So check out that Fundamentals membership if you're interested in that. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this. Give these dancers shout out. Give them a shout out on social media. Share this video. Let them know that I appreciate them because this is amazing. And hopefully I get a chance to hear your feedback on this video on these people's dancing. It was fantastic. Let me know what you thought in the comment section. And if I don't see you in one of my classes online, hopefully I get to hear your opinion in the comment section of my next reaction video. Take care.